After resisting a house called the Battery Brothers, she took them into the spaceship and put them on their place, the cell. They were not alone. Someone was already there. Her name was Betty. Everything was going so well for us. Maybe too well.
Why relax? Tell the pilot we finished here.
Resistina was acting comfortable as ever, and so did I. Then I left her alone in there, and I went to the command room. So I let our pilot know we are ready to go. She was the sweetie, Fuzzy. Fuzzy was also another soldier from Omniland, just like Resistina.
Well done, Lampcat. Let's start our engines.
Our power came from Ace.
It's time to go.
Ace is the spaceship's AC power supply. We basically drain his energy. Before we continue the story, do you know the difference between AC and DC energy? We have seen already examples of DC energy, like the Battery Brothers and Betty. DC stands for direct current, and it always has a positive and negative terminal. As examples, we can have direct current device, such as DC power supply and battery. Like the battery in your remote control or cell phone. But what about our home's power plugs? We cannot spot which pin is the positive or the negative one, right? Those power plugs are like ACE, AC energy. AC stands for alternating current, and it has neither positive nor negative. So we have two distinct types of energy, AC and DC. To understand the difference between them, first, take a look at these symbols. They will be used in circuit diagrams. In this circuit, we have a DC charge and a light bulb. The bigger bar in the DC charge symbol, it is its positive pole, and the smaller one is the negative one. And this is the symbol for a light bulb, just like this one on my head. As we saw in the last episode, the electrons flow from the negative to the positive, and that will make the light bulb lit. But what happens if you replace the DC charge with an AC one? We are using the same light bulb, and we do know the alternating current has neither positive nor negative terminal. As the name says, alternating current, the ends of an AC power supply alternates between negative and positive. In other words, negative and positive terminals are not fixed. They are constantly alternating over and over again. Now, let's take a look at them graphically. We have voltage, V, over the time, T. Here is a typical DC voltage graphical representation, and that is an AC one. But we can have many of them. A straight line like this will be always representing a DC energy. And this one is also a DC one. And this is also DC. Here, one more DC energy. Observe that they were never crossed the voter's zero line. That's why they are all DC. The shape doesn't really matter. Now we have an AC energy in here. Observe that they are all cross the voltage's zero line. That's why they are AC. And what about that one? It is DC, it doesn't cross the zero line, and it is also a straight line. It's only upside down. I hope now you can see a clear difference between AC and DC. And let's go back to our story now. The prisoners were in an awkward situation and they knew they had to do something. Resistina was alone and asleep. So they took action, carefully and quickly. Breaking all the chains by short-circuiting them with the electric power. It was now or never. They were going to break free. A fierce fight for freedom and revenge.
It's payback time now.
Was about to start.